fellow racers. Thanks for coming back to Lights Out Siena. Today I have my first show guest, the Euro NASCAR Series racer, the amazing Julia Landauer. She's originally from New York City, like me, and now lives in North Carolina, where she does her NASCAR training. Since we're practicing social distancing, I caught up with her on a video call. She gives a lot of good information for young, hopeful racers. Hi, Julia. First, I want to ask you, what is your favorite thing about being a NASCAR driver?
What I love about being a NASCAR driver is that when you're on an oval, the racing is so intense, and it's side-to-side action, front-to-back action. Things can change so quickly, so I find the racing to be really, really exciting, and usually it's moving around a lot, and there's a lot of passing that's going on, and there are so many things you have to think about all at one time, and I just find it really invigorating.
So, what's it like to train as a NASCAR driver?
Training as a NASCAR driver is really interesting, and I think a lot of non-racing fans might not realize how physical the sport is, but imagine you're strapped tightly into your seat and you're muscling around 3,400 pounds of machine for hours on end. The motor is in the front of the car, so it can be up to 130 or 40 degrees in the car, and you're doing this for hours. So it's really, really stressful on the body and on the mind. And so I work with Podium Performance Fitness, which is here in North Carolina, and we do a lot of very specific motorsports training, like neurological training and reaction times with apps, and then we do a lot of heat training, and we do strength and conditioning and cardio, and I really love running, so I use that to get my endurance training in, and there's a lot of really cool stuff, including neck training, because in racing you crash, and they notice that the more you crash, the more likely you are to get a concussion, and so by being able to train the neck, we're hopefully delaying the onset of concussion.
Wow, that's a lot of hard work. So, were you racing while you were in college? And how did you know you wanted to be a NASCAR driver after college?
I went to Stanford University, where I got a Bachelor's of Science in Science, Technology, and Society. And I was racing while I was in college, a little bit during the spring of my junior year, but then also during the summers when I was in college. And I've been racing since I was 10. So by the time I went into school, I knew that I really wanted to be a race car driver professionally. And my plan was always to go to school, keep racing as much as I could, and then to move to North Carolina to pursue my NASCAR career. So it worked out really well, and it was really exciting to be able to marry my world of racing and with school.
That's cool. Can you tell us if you ever crashed in a NASCAR race?
Yes, most race car drivers have crashed at some point in their life. And sometimes it can be really scary, it can be really fast paced, it can be when you're going really fast. It can also be slower crashes, like coming out of a corner, so there's a lot of different ways that you can crash, unfortunately. But I had one that was really scary when I was racing in Ford Focus Midgets when I was 16, and my axle snapped through a corner, just total freak accident, and I didn't have brakes, and I couldn't control the car, and I just went head on into a wall. And I hurt my knee a little bit, but I was able to get fixed and heal, and then go on to the next race.
That's such a crazy story. Okay, Julia, now, what advice would you give to your 10-year-old self?
If I had a piece of advice for my 10-year-old self, I would tell little Julia not to focus on what other people think of you. When you're going through life, there is no way that you're going to be able to please everybody. And so if you're able to focus on what you like, what you want, what your values are, it'll take you a lot further, and you'll be able to do what you want to do with conviction.
That's great advice for anyone. And lastly, what advice would you give to me and other kids who are interested in becoming professional drivers one day?
I think it's so great to hear of young girls and women who want to be race car drivers, and I think that's awesome. And the biggest thing for no matter what you want to do in life is to do your homework and to know everything you can about what goes into it. So what goes into racing? How do you get into go-karting? How do you move up to cars? What resources do you need? What funding do you need? Going through all these questions. The other thing is to get out into the community, whether you can visit places that have a lot of racing or try to connect with retired racers or active racers or teams, to learn as much as you can and get used to the community. It's interesting because I was raised in New York City, I felt like an outsider for a lot of my time in racing. And the more time I spent with racers in the communities, in North Carolina, in California, the more comfortable I got. And so it's all about networking. It's all about finding the right people and practicing. And if you can't physically get into a vehicle, then maybe doing simulator work, watching videos, visualizing, it's all really important. But at the end of the day, you also just have to love what you do and to never give up and to keep pushing hard. And the road will be bumpy and it might not go the way you want it to go, but if you keep with it, you should be able to find some success.
That is some great tips. Thank you so much, Julia, for taking the time to talk to me. I can't wait till motorsports starts again, and we can see Julia and all the other NASCAR and F1 drivers on the tracks again. That's it for today, and thank you so much for watching F1 Siena. See you soon. Bye.